Hello friends, how are you all? My name is Harshit Dwivedi and in this video I am going to tell you about the chairman and deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha. This is a very brief video. I have already made a video on the speaker and deputy speaker. Before watching this video on deputy chairman and chairman of the Rajya Sabha, please go back friends and watch the video on speaker, deputy speaker and speaker pro tem of the Lok Sabha that I have already made. So this will be easy for you to understand this video. Now first I am going to talk about the chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is the presiding officer of the Rajya Sabha presiding officer is also known by the designation of the chairman of Rajya Sabha, and obviously the vice president of India is the ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. So very first thing that comes into our mind is that chairman of Rajya Sabha is not a member of Rajya Sabha. Okay, he is the vice president of India. Now when the president of India is unable to perform its duties, vice president of India performs the duties of the president. This is his duty. When president is not present, the chairman of a Rajya Sabha can be removed only when the vice president of India is removed, and the process of removal of vice president of India I have already discussed in the vice president lecture. Go back to my vice president lecture and have a look at it. The salaries and allowances of the vice president of India are friends charged on the consolidated fund of India. That is, they cannot be reduced to his disadvantage after his appointment. Charged means they are directly chargeable on the consolidated fund of India and they are not subject to vote of any other member of the parliament. Then comes that whenever the Vice President of India acts as the President of India, he will be given the allowances and remuneration of the President of India and not the Vice President. This is one point. Also, when the resolution for the removal of Vice President of India is under consideration, then he cannot preside over the proceedings of the Rajya Sabha. But he can be present, he can take part in the proceedings, he can speak on the floor of the house, but he cannot vote in the first instance. So here comes the difference with the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. In the Speaker of the Lok Sabha lecture, I have told you friends that when a resolution for the removal of the Speaker is under consideration, Speaker can take part in the proceedings and he can also vote in the first instance. But when we talk about the Chairman of the Rajya Sabha, when a resolution for removal of the Chairman of the Rajya Sabha is under consideration, he can take part in the proceedings but cannot vote in the first instance. This is one point. Also, when the chairman is presiding over the Rajya Sabha, he has the power of a casting vote in the event of a tie. You understand friends? That means that for example, if there are 250 members in the Rajya Sabha, 125 are in favor of the a particular bill, 125 are in against a particular bill. So obviously, I'm just taking an example, the 250 is the total strength of the Rajya Sabha, that I know friends. Okay. And 245 is current strength, but I've just taken an example. So if 250 members are there, 125 in favor, 125 in against. So this is a tie. So one, now the chairman will have a casting vote in order to bring an outcome. Also, many of the functions and powers of the chairman of Rajya Sabha are similar to that of the speaker of Lok Sabha, but there are some differences. That differences I'm going to talk about. There are basically four differences. First difference is that the speaker has the power to certify whether a particular bill is a money bill or not. Rajya Sabha chairman has no such power. Second thing is that the speaker has the power to vote in the first instance, which is not available to the chairman of Rajya Sabha when a resolution for their removal is under the consideration of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha respectively. This point I have already discussed before. Third coming, when a joint sitting of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha is called, speaker of Lok Sabha presides over it. There is no such power available to the chairman of Rajya Sabha. And fourth, speaker of Lok Sabha is a member of Lok Sabha and is being chosen from among them, but chairman of Rajya Sabha is not a member of the Rajya Sabha. He is the vice president of India. Now we are going to talk about the deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha friends. The deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha, actually, it is very much similar to the deputy speaker of the Lok Sabha. The duties of the chairman are being looked after by the deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha when the chairman is not present for some reasons. Also, deputy chairman office is not subordinate to the chairman of Rajya Sabha. That office of deputy chairman is directly responsible to the Rajya Sabha. No, he is not directly responsible to the chairman of Rajya Sabha, that is the vice president. Deputy chairman is a member of the Rajya Sabha and he is elected by the members of Rajya Sabha from among themselves. Salaries and allowances are decided by the parliament of the deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha and they are charged upon the consolidated fund of India. The meaning of charged must have been clear to you by now. In order to leave his post, if the deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha wants to resign, then he has to address his resignation to the chairman of the Rajya Sabha, that is to the vice president of India. if a deputy chairman has to be removed by the Rajya Sabha, then a resolution has to be supported by an absolute majority of the Rajya Sabha. What is the meaning of absolute majority? I have already told you. The functions and powers of deputy speaker are very, very similar to the deputy speaker of the Lok Sabha. Of the deputy chairman are very, very similar to the deputy speaker of the Lok Sabha. So these are the very, very important points about the chairman and deputy chairman of the Rajya Sabha, friends. I hope this was clear to you. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section below. Thank you for being patient, friends. Have a nice day.